Evening, Vicar. Out for a walk?
That's right. I'm taking the night air.
Oh, you're a bit off the beaten track, aren't you? There ain't no churches round here.
No. would you mind moving your walking frame? I'd like to pass.
That depends.
Depends? Depends on what?
Money, Vicar. Hand over your wallet and you won't get hurt.
Certainly not. Unless you leave me alone, I shall call the police.
Oh, hear that, Walter. He's going to call the police.
Oh, no. Oh, I'm so scared.
Oh, my goodness. What are you going to do with that broken sonatogen bottle?
This is your last chance, Vicar.
What?
Give us your wallet or else.
The bishop to see you, Reverend Carswell.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Knobloch.
Don't get up, Carswell. How are you feeling?
Well, I haven't stopped shaking yet. I mean, you read about people being mugged, but you never think it will happen to you.
You've only yourself to blame. You should know better than to walk past the Darby and Joan Club after dark. Oh, even the police don't do that.
Well, this has always been a tough neighbourhood, but I didn't realise things had got so bad.
This evening's incident has convinced me of one thing, Carswell. You don't belong in an inner-city parish like this.
You should be out
in the suburbs, judging flower shows and holding coffee mornings.
Oh, well, perhaps you're right, Your Grace.
One of my longest-serving ministers has recently retired. How would you like to take over his parish?
Well, I'm not sure, Your Grace. What's it like?
Very quiet, very sedate, very residential. Just the sort of place you'd feel most at home.
Oh.
By all accounts, Rosewood Avenue is a lovely place to live, but not much ever happens there.
The Secret Life of Rosewood Avenue, written by Stephen Sheridan and starring James Grout as the Reverend Carswell. Episode 1, Moving In.
Is it much further, Mr. Cudlip? I told my new housekeeper I'd be there by 4.
Oh, we're almost there. Do you see where I'm pointing? That's the spot of your new church.
Do keep your hands on the steering wheel. That almost hit us.
I expect Rosewood Avenue is going to seem rather tame. After an inner city parish, we're a bit of a backwater out here.
Oh dear, I was afraid of that.
Look around you, sir. Cars being washed, lawns being mown. That's as exciting as it ever gets.
Oh.
A car backfired last week. 3 people died of shock.
Oh, dear. but who knows what's going on behind those net curtains, eh? Hmm? Perhaps all sorts of tense human dramas are being played out.
Oh, I doubt it, sir. I've lived in Rosewood Avenue 7 years, and I haven't seen a tense human drama yet.
Welcome to the rectory, Reverend Carswell. I'm your housekeeper, Mrs. Muir.
I'm sorry we're late, Mrs. Muir. My car broke down at the bottom of 5 Mile Hill, and the Reverend had to push it the rest of the way.
Never mind. I expect the exercise will have done me good.
I hope Reverend Carswell behaved himself, Mr. Cudlip.
Oh, don't worry, Mrs. Muir. He was as good as gold.
Well, that's very kind. I'll just...
And
I'll
where
just
do you think you're off to, Reverend Carswell?
Pardon? I'm feeling rather tired. I thought I'd lie down for 10 minutes.
You'd be better off working on your sermon, sir. It's evensong at 6.
Well, surely I'm not expected to conduct a service today. I've just travelled 70 miles.
Hard work never killed anyone, sir. Everyone in the avenue was looking forward to their first glimpse of you.
Your arrival's the most exciting event of the year. Like I said, Reverend Carswell, not much happens in Rosewood Avenue.
Finished doing that, he ran.
before that last lovely hymn. Church-going has something of an image problem these days. Many people find the ritual and ceremony irrelevant, obsolete, and perhaps even a little dull.
Isn't he ever going to finish?
It doesn't have to be like that. As this is the first sermon in my new church, I'd like to read a list of methods by which I will strive to make my Sunday service inspiring, stimulating, and above all, exciting. When I sat down to write it, I thought I might come up with 20 methods, or 30 at the most. But do you know how many I came up with in the end? 972. Method one. I will ensure that my sermons are always brief, witty, and to the point.
You were very strict with Reverend Carswell, Mrs. Muir. Did you really have to stand over him with a stick while he wrote his sermon?
It's best to start as you mean to go on, Mr. Cudlip. Spare the rod and you'll spoil the vicar.
I suppose you'll be kept busy helping the Reverend settle in.
Why do you ask?
The ice rink has just reopened in town. Mm. If you've nothing better to do on Monday evening, I thought you might like to come skating with me.
Oh, how many more times, Mr. Cudlip? I don't want to go out with you any more. Why can't you accept that?
Oh, it's not easy, Mrs. Muir. You know how I feel about you. I've tried putting you out of my mind, but I just can't do it.
I have a prior engagement on Monday evening. Dr. Warlock has invited me to a wine tasting in the pathology labs of Cheney Street General.
Oh, Warlock, Warlock, Warlock. That's all I ever hear. Before that viper came on the scene, we used to go out once or twice a week. Now you're hardly given the time of day.
I think you'd better leave, Mr. Cudlip. I'm not willing to listen to you calling Dr. Warlock rude names.
Please come skating with me, Mrs. Muir. Just once more. Please, Mrs. Muir.
I shall say this one last time. There is only one man in my life, and that man is Dr. Warlock. The sooner you knuckle down and accept it, the happier you'll be.
4.5 hours, Frank! Oh, I thought he was never going to finish. 4.5 hours!
It's over now, dear.
Thank you so much for coming. I hope to see you again next Sunday. Thank you.
Welcome to Rosewood Avenue, Reverend Carswell. We thought your sermon was absolutely marvellous.
Oh, thank you very much. I didn't have long to work on it, so I was worried I'd made it too short.
Do you know what happened to the poor lady who suffered a panic attack?
I saw a couple of gentlemen making a stretcher out of their overcoats. I expect they carried her home.
You gave me quite a start, Reverend Carswell. She seemed to snap when you said you'd just thought of another 20 methods.
I hope she didn't hurt you too badly, dear.
I'll probably just have one or two bruises on my throat for the next few days, that's all.
Well, women of her age don't have much stamina, I'm afraid. We developed our powers of endurance during the war.
We were both in the land army, that's where we met.
How fascinating. You must tell me all about it sometime.
Why don't you come to tea tomorrow afternoon, Reverend Carswell?
Well, that's a very kind offer. I'd absolutely love to.
I'm Dorothy Tilling, dear. And this is my companion, Miss Tapp.
This is delicious, Mrs. Muir. I haven't eaten semolina since I was at school.
Oh, it was always a particular favourite of Reverend Maxwell's, sir.
I never met my predecessor. What sort of man was he?
Oh, very shy and secretive, sir. I was very fond of him, even though he did sometimes say I treated him like a child.
Oh, really?
Don't talk with your mouth full, sir. It's rude.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He spent most days locked in his study. He had a little printing press in there, and he used it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.